Hello. So, in the introductory video of this course, I told you about that the best way to practice Junos and look at the functionality of different features and technologies that are implemented in Junos software on developer devices. The best thing is to have access to the physical device itself. These Juniper devices are not really that much costly. You say before recording of this lecture, I was quickly glancing over the options that are available through eBay, and look at this. This one is Juniper SRX. It's a small office device that normally small corporate offices have with them, and it's only £138. Likewise, if I go up, these are a bit expensive, and if you go high, you can find even more expensive devices. But another search that I got through, and I just wanted to show you that this J series device, it is only costing $86. So if you can have that, a device which is less than $100, it would be better for you for because you see there is no match as compared to the actual physical device. You can emulate it, but that will be a emulated environment, or it's not a simulation, it's an emulation, because actual Junos software gets run on the on your personal computer or maybe on your laptop. But it's better to have access to the physical device to power it up, to plug in the cables and actually interact with the device, because that's how you will interact actually on the job or wherever you are working. But if due to some reason or the other you cannot have your hands onto the physical device, there are a couple of ways that you can work around. One of the possible options is that you can create a virtual device through VMware or maybe in a VirtualBox. I have used VirtualBox for this purpose, but you can also use VMware, and my GNS3 version that I am going to emulate these virtual devices in is a bit outdated, but new versions of GNS3, they are natively supporting VMware. My version is only supporting VirtualBox, so I'll be using VirtualBox to demonstrate how to emulate Junos software in the GNS3 platform. And the other way to do that is that you can get a Junos image from scratch, build it up by using Kimu options. And before this option came out in the market, people used to work using this option. And what essentially this means that we have a free BSD image, and we also have a Junos image that we need to get from, in fact, Juniper, but you can Google it around and find it on the internet. And after that, getting that image, let's say this is the Junos image. After getting these two, you need to enable or try to modify this Junos image into an Olive image which actually runs onto your PC or your device. So Olive is the term, and it really is the software. If there's a device and you are running Junos software on it, then that and that software is making your device acting, your PC or your laptop acting as a networking device. It can route the packets or maybe polish them or all the functions that are supported by that particular software version, then that will be called as Olive. So either you can employ this method or you can have the virtual machine. This method over here, the one with the Kimu, is a bit lengthy and also takes a lot of time to configure the Junos software to be compatible with GNS3. But I have used it and it does work well. But there is a gotcha in here as well. This software, if you are using this patched versions of Kimu and you are trying to implement firewall policies which we will see in the upcoming lectures, if we try to implement firewall policies using the images that are created through this method, these policies, they are taken by the device, but they do not have any effect. You will see the configuration stanzas over there, but you will see that the firewall configuration is not working. It is not stopping or dropping the packets, but the configuration lines will be there. So you will be kind of, you know, taken back that why it is happening. So this is one of the limitations that I know about. So for firewall features specifically, you need to have this one, and this one is easy as well. But worry not, I am also going to tell you that how you can use this option as well, because this is pretty good. It takes less memory and basic functionality you can achieve with this one as well. The option that where you compile the Junos image using Kemu. And I'm not going to perform the actual Junos build up image because as I said that it takes a lot of time, maybe a couple of hours, and we really do not want to do that at this time. You can do it at yourself. I'm just going to show you the method that you can use to do it at yourself, and I'm also going to include the link in the file attached with this lecture so that you can do it at your own. So let me just pull up the browser and show you the brief. Now this is the forum from GNS3, and this is the link over here. I will copy and paste this link in the text file attached with this lecture so that you can download that, and if you want to, you can create this olive image at your own. So there are a couple of things. Just if we bring down here, these are the main options that you need to be aware of. You need to have free BSD image. If I bring it down over here, so these are the files. You need to have the FreeBSD image, and you also need to have the Junos version, which you can search around and download from the search engines. After you get those two images, just follow these instructions, and hopefully if everything goes well, which I believe if you follow this instruction to the exactly as they have been mentioned, you should have no problem in getting your Juniper device up and running. These instructions have both been made for Linux or Windows. I myself am using Linux software, so I followed the Linux based instruction. But if you are using Windows operating system, you can use Windows. Now, once you are successfully able to make the Junos image, you will have a file of size around 1.7 GB, and let me just show you over here that where is that file. Let me just bring it up for you. Alright, so this is the FreeBSD image. It's around 250 MB, and this is the gInstall package that you can Google around and download, and these are the couple of files that are available in the script or this link that I have shown you. You will need those files to make your olive image. Now once you have those, the image that will be made is something like this, which is of img file extension, and size is around 1.7 GB. Now once you have that image, you need to import it in your GNS3, and the way to do that is that you set the Kemu options and go into Junos, and I have created these four instances of Junos. I have given it a RAM of 512 MB, and the number of MIPS that it is supporting is 6. By default it is 6, you can reduce or enhance it if you want to, and the NIC model is E1000. So, and also you need to enable this check mark, this option, which is KVM or virtualization option, but only if you are using, of course, Linux-based operating system. Now, once all this is done, you can simply, you know, drag this Juniper router over here and simply power it up. So this one, like over here, just give it a second till it boots up, completes its boot sequence, and then we will get the form for that. Just hang on, just wait for a second, and this is booting up. Just give it some time. Now, while this is booting up, let me also tell you that other option that we were talking about, which is through virtual machines. And I told you that I'm going to show about the installation of Junos image in VirtualBox. Now let's quickly have a look if our machine has booted up, which it has. And we have the prompt, and now we can enter in the device by giving the username and the correct password. Now for the second option, if you open up the link that I've told you about, you will get to this screen, where it says that you can download. This is one of the download links that I have searched on the search engines, but you can find out the other links if you want to. But I'm at the moment is using this OLLI version 12.1 with Debian 1.9 for VirtualBox. Now we click this one and the image gets downloaded. Once it gets downloaded, you get to this image over here. Now you can directly import this one into virtual machine. I imported it, but for my particular version of VirtualBox, this was not working. So what I really did is that I extracted the disk file from this image, and you can do that as well. Let me just bring it in. So these are three files that are placed in that OVA file. I can extract this file into that particular folder, and once it gets extracted, we will import it in the VirtualBox. So here's the file that I have extracted from OVA, and let me just pull up the VirtualBox interface, which is over here. And now we are gonna create the new machine. Now this Junos, it is based on FreeBSD. So we need to create a machine, an instance of a device which is based on FreeBSD. So I'm gonna do that. Let's just name it Juniper. You can name it anything that you want to, and so that VirtualBox knows that what kind of machine we are creating. I have given it the type of BSD, and it has auto selected this FreeBSD. Now click next. I have used 512 MB. Which is sufficient for emulating a Juniper device, but it's better if you have more RAM. You can give it up to 1 GB. So I have selected 1 GB. Let's click next. And over here, let it create a new disk. And the disk type that it should have is VMDK, because that is the file type that we have created over here, which we will be importing for this particular scenario. Now click next over here, and it is asking for the disk storage detail. Let's just click next so that it can dynamically allocate the space. At the moment, 2 GB is more than enough. Click next over here, and it is saying that it is already existed because I created it earlier. Click just next. And after that, you click on create. So once all is done, a machine is created in your VirtualBox terminal by the name of Juniper. Just change a couple of seconds settings. Click on the settings tab and come to the system. Over here, let's just check processor, enable physical address extension, and also make sure that hardware virtualization is selected. Now coming on to storage part, this is where we select the disk that we had just extracted from the OVA file. I click on this option and I choose this particular disk. Let me just bring it in the terminal so that it is visible for you. So this is the file that we had extracted. I click open and now this file is selected. I click OK and the image is now final. Now to make it available in the GNS3, let's open up GNS3 terminal again and just remove this one and come on to the preferences option. If you are using a different version of GNS3, you might have these options available in a different way, but just try to understand and get the idea that we go to the virtual box and then virtual box guest. I refresh the list of available VMs and I select Juniper that we have just created. Let's just name it Juniper, and the number of NICs that we want to have is it could be 2, so let's leave it 2 or maybe 6 interfaces. NIC model is automatic. Enable console support, and you can leave this check mark to reserve first NIC, but I do not want to reserve any NIC for netting to the host OS. And after this part is done, also enable console server for remote access, or you can leave it if you do not want to. Also, you can give this option that the device should be started in headless mode so that the terminal window of the virtual box does not appear. Rather, the status is started in the background. So we can check mark this option as well. Now once this is done, let's save it and close these options and come on to the virtual box guest over here and select the machine that we have just created. We can change the symbol, anything that we want to, so let's just change it to a regular router one. Now let's run it. Click start and also put on the console. And we see that the boot sequence has started. Just give it a while. Once the router has fully booted up, we can see this prompt amnesiac, and we can type in the username as root, and the default is password is none. So we are at the FreeBSD prompt. Over here we type in CLI to get to the router prompt. So that's how you can emulate Junos device on your own system, your PC or maybe your laptop, using VirtualBox. And also, if you want to try it, do give it a try, the other option that I told you about, using the Chemo one. This is also a very good option for emulating Junos on to your GNS3 software running on your PC or laptop. I hope you have learned from this video, and I would like to thank you for viewing.